Good afternoon and welcome to this live interview Dobar dan from Strasbourg, from the European Parliament. Ovaj intervju uživo iz Strasbourga iz Evropskog parlamenta. Ja sam Robert iz medijskog tima parlamentu. Govorit ćemo ovdje o dodjeli LUX nagrada, dakle nagrade parlamenta za kinematografiju u saradnji sa Evropskom filmskom akademijom. Ova nagrada je upravo dodjeljena pobjedniku ove godine, a upravo je to film bosanskoj produkciji Kovade Saida. S nama je gospođa Žbanić, dobrodošli. I također s nama je danas i gospođa Subašić, da preživjela majka Srebreničkog masakra, i hvala vam što ste s nama se pridružili. Ova, dakle, LUX nagrada uključuje, dakle, producente, distributore, festivalske režisere i tako dalje. Ovi godine su tri, od komisije sastav od ovih, dakle, tri filma su odabrana i LUX nagrada je dodijeljena. Dakle, i Filipa sa velikom slobodom, nazvan za Sebastianom nagradom. Dakle, jedini parlament je jedini together in cooperation with film industry professionals that have worked in such a variety. Screenings of all the nominated movies have been organized all over Europe and are still taking place. So please go and visit the official page of luxaward.eu if you still want to see one of the nominated films. Kovade Saida is a film about the Srebrenica massacre in 1995, in July 1995, during the Bosnian War, in which more than 8,000 Bosnian, mostly men and boys, were killed, sheltering in the so-called UN safe area, were slaughtered by the Bosnian Serb forces under General Ratko Mladic, the biggest civilian massacre in Europe since World War II. The story follows Aida, a school teacher turned interpreter for the UN peacekeeping forces based in Srebrenica. Congratulations again, Jasmila Žbanić. What does this award mean to you, and what does it mean to be awarded such a prize by a wider European audience together with the members of the European Parliament?
Yeah, I'm very honored. This nomination already was a great thing because it was organized in such a good way that 400 cinemas all over Europe showed a film, had audience there and had Q&As. So it was really amazing work of LUX team to inform audience about it, and I think all three films give a perspective on what is Europe today. Award is of course wonderful because it gives more light to the film. It was a great opportunity today to talk in the European Parliament because I think some issues of our film in Bosnia are still very present and they are still endangering Bosnia and people who live there. And for me, as we are not EU country, it was very crucial to talk about it today with European members.
Tell us about the process of telling this story through Aida, this teacher. She's the example of countless mothers and sisters who lost their close ones. But why did you choose to tell the story through her?
Aida is a fictional character, but her, what I learned from survivors, what I learned from documents, from books, from talking to people who were examining what happened in Srebrenica, watching, I watched a lot of footage from that time. I talked to many people who analyzed what happened. So I decided to have a female character, to have a female perspective on the events. Not only that, a lot of films that are showing war, very often, even if they are done by women or done by anti-war directors, they have very often a spectacle of war involved in a narrative. And because I survived the siege of Sarajevo and I know what happened in Srebrenica, I thought there is nothing spectacular about the war. War is banality of evil, and that's how I wanted to present it. I was inspired by women of Srebrenica, like Munira. They have organizations who are changing Bosnian society. They are they are women who lost their sons and members of the family and husbands, but they are still fighting for truth, fighting for reconciliation in our area. They are calling for peace and never spreading any words of hatred, any gestures of hatred, just always talking, we have to live together, we have to go on, but we have to know the truth and we have to make war criminals prosecuted. So they were my main inspiration, because when I, there was a lot of obstacle to make this film, but whenever I thought, okay, I give up, then I look at them and then I think I have no right to give up, because what they survived is unbelievable.
What were some of the obstacles, if you could briefly mention?
I mean, we had a lot of obstacles, starting with, we still have people in the government that are supporting war criminals, and they didn't want this film to happen. So we had a lot of problems with getting some, permissions to shoot. Like mayor of Srebrenica, he denies that genocide ever happened. We were not allowed to shoot there. We couldn't get some military equipment because people who need to sign it, they are promoting war criminals. They say Srebrenica never happened. They think Ratko Mladic and other war criminals are heroes. So there was a lot of political issues that wanted to block the film, but we were really persistent in our decision to do it.
Mrs. Subacic, you just heard about war denial, and this is something that occurs a lot, not only here in Europe but also in other parts of the world. There are still people who try to deny, to erase history. And you are one of those mothers of Srebrenica who has been telling this story for 27 years. Your story, you lost your family, your son, and your husband and relatives. You now shared it with the whole world. Why is this important to you?
Prvo moram da kažem, da vas ispravim, da nije tamo bio masakar, nego da je tamo bio genocid.
First, I have to correct you that it wasn't a massacre in Srebrenica, but a genocide. It's not the same thing. There are court judgments and decisions. I cannot allow to this be called a massacre. We have to refer to it as a genocide. Because unless we talk, things will be forgotten. In order not for this to be repeated, with my grandchildren and so on, for them to go through the same experience, we have to speak the truth at all times, and we have to wait for the justice to be done. And we are not, we haven't been doing this for anyone to make causing pain or to anyone to suffer. We want only those who are responsible for atrocities to be brought to justice. We have to make distinction between normal people and those who are villains. The people have to be divided by their names and their deeds, not by their ethnicity. Bosnia-Herzegovina is a specific country which is divided in two entities. In the entity where I lived, if I come to municipality, I come for a document or the clerk, because and I have to pay some fee, was the Serb mother who doesn't have to pay. Republika Srpska, they call everything, they give it an adjective, Srpski, meaning Serb, belonging to Serbs. We have to fight against injustice and to create a better future. I cannot allow my three grandchildren to be deprived of the truth, of veracity. I will tell them the truth, but I will also teach them to know that they are good and bad people. So my daughter and I lost also that. We are still seeking justice. They're still looking for a bones of our children. We haven't heard all these years that somebody say, forgive us, we are doing. Willy Brandt was not reborn in Bosnia. Willy Brandt is an example how Germans he assumed responsibility for the atrocities committed by the Nazis in Germanism. So they are giving compensation to victims. They are having words in the entity where I live, Zlatko Mladic and other war crime. Criminals are being glorified.
There are no pisaca, ko što je bilo kad sam ja išla u školu. Tamo su fotografije
photographs slava, of the writers that were taught about when I went to school. There are photographs of some ex-generals like Ratko Mladic and so on. So Bošnjak children, they do not have their language. We are the only people, Bošnjaks. We don't have our language. Is not in use. There's a Croatian language for Croats and Serb for Serbian. Our language is called the Bošnjak language in Republika Srpska. I want it to be called Bosnian. There are thousands and thousands of instances of injustice in this entity. I think that many mothers think the same way as I do, and we are cooperating. If all politicians were to cooperate in the way that we have been doing, I think that our country would be the most prosperous one.
How do these stories, the stories of other mothers, help the world to know, and especially also people who are living in Bosnia now, across communities connect with each other? And for instance, is the story of the film Kovadis Aida also a story that can connect people, no matter where they come from in Bosnia?
Da. Da. Pa Jasmila je sa ovim filmom pokazala ono sve što smo mi preživljavali.
Jasmila
actually
presented in her movie everything what we experienced. She did it in an artistic way. When the Srebrenica are falling, we mothers, we did all we could to save our children. Unfortunately, we failed. But when this all ended, we tried to find out the truth. But we cannot find the truth from each other. We needed to find out the truth from Serb mothers and Croatian mothers from the other entity, because they witnessed crimes. So this is why we organized an NGO. It's not possible that only Bošnjaks were killed and not others, because people, if they wage war, like for example now in Ukraine, Russians attack Ukraine, but Ukraine soldiers are dying, but as well as Russian soldiers. So also in Bosnia, the Bosniaks were killed, but the Serbs and Croatians as well. So we appeal to mother's love for children, and we believe that mothers have that in common, that we can exchange this sentiment or share it and try to help each other to find remains of our dearest. Our strength and demonstrated easily and also incited and awakened people who for many years had no idea what was happening. Because you must remember there was a UN flag in Srebrenica at the time when this genocide was committed. And the Europe itself didn't do anything after the genocide. We got the law was endorsed on the prohibition of negation of genocide after 26 years. This law should have been adopted 2 or 3 years after the war. There was evidence, there were witnesses, and about what happened in Slovenia. So Europe was also troubled, but unfortunately, if the law had been endorsed a long time ago, maybe Ukraine would have never happened. Many children are being killed, many mothers are crying, and who has the right to take another person's life? Whoever is born has the right to live.
Jasmila, we see history as Mrs. Shabazi said, we see history being repeated again in Europe with the brutal aggression of Russian aggression on Ukraine and the killing of innocent civilians. Seeing all this unfold, what parallels can be drawn to what happened in Srebrenica? And do you think, are there any lessons learned to take into account?
Prije svega ja sam, sorry, I will go in English. First of all, I thought after war in Bosnia that it will never be a war in Europe. I thought that Europe learned a lesson that the fascistic forces has to be stopped from very beginning, that you cannot, let them grow. I was very shocked with the news about the war. It triggered a lot of sadness in all Bosnia. People were really, really traumatized by reappearing of the war in Europe. The system is very similar. There are a lot of lies, a lot of false justification why war is happening. I recognize the same system. Serbia was saying, oh, there are Serbs living in Bosnia, we will take the part to liberate them. So it was the same
and
what happened.
There are scenes in the movie of Mladic going around with a camera,
yes.
And as soon as the camera was off,
the propaganda machinery was so strong, and that is a preparation for war. That was also happening in ex-Yugoslavia, the same thing in Russia. One thing that Europe learned, because during Bosnian war we were not allowed to defend ourselves. We had arms embargo from EU, from international community. For 4 years we were fighting with no weapons, with the fourth strongest army in Europe, which was Yugoslav army, that turned into Serbian army. So at least Europe learned something, so they allowed Ukrainians to defend themselves. This is, I think, the lesson they learned in Bosnia. But what is still not there, I was today listening a little bit of the speech of the Ukrainian representative, and the European Union was promising so much. I doubt that this will happen, all these promises.
Back then.
I think the only solution is to stop the war as soon as possible. If we let this war happen for 4 years, Europe will be devastated. So that's how I feel. Because of this experience of war, I recognize many similarities, and I recognize that it will be devastation of Europe.
Mrs. Subasic, I just want to take it from where Jasmila left it. The world has witnessed the war in Ukraine, as I was saying, but it has witnessed it unfold in a different way. While every Ukrainian rushed to tell their story through their little smartphones, to the lenses of their smartphones.
I'm sorry, she's not hearing it at the moment, the translation.
Do you hear the translation? Mm-hmm. I have it in my ear. Excuse me. Good.
Okay, translation is working.
As I was saying, the world is witnessing now the war in Ukraine through the lenses of the smartphones of Ukrainians who rush to tell their stories to the whole world on social media. Back then, these tools were not available 27 years ago in Bosnia or everywhere in the world. If this communication or if these tools existed back then, do you think that there would be a more rapid reaction to what happened to the Bosnians? Do you think that the genocide would have been avoided?
Ne, pa genocid je planiran i nije mogao počiniti to jedan čovjek.
No, genocide was planned. It couldn't be done by one person or even a group of people, and it was done by an academia, and even it enjoyed some support from some European elements. So there was this theory that Muslims needed to be destroyed. But I would like to stress that we were in Europe before the war. As a Bosniak woman, I worked in the village, but I went to school, I was educated. My children went to the seaside, skiing and so on. We were very, very much advanced then in comparison to Romania, Bulgaria and so on, the countries that are now EU members. However, somebody didn't like the unity that existed in the former Yugoslavia. We all worked, we had a good standard of living. And we're not concerned about ethnicity at all. However, somebody didn't like it. In 1995, in Srebrenica, not only Bosniaks were killed, Roma people were killed as well, Croatians, Catholics, all who were in Srebrenica at the time and who were not Serbs have been killed. So in our memorial center we have people, majority are Bosniaks, but there are others as well, Croats and Roma people and so on. Well, yeah, indeed, if the things were different with this social network, probably larger public would be better informed. But Amprofor was stationed in Srebrenica in 1995. They had a good telecommunication tools. I think it was more up to the policy. We sued the Ministry of Defense, we as an association. The responsibility, but the Netherlands, actually the Ministry of Defense of Netherlands, and they accepted partially their responsibility, then the Hague Tribunal and so on, so that there will be a compensation paid to some families who have missing relatives or killed relatives and so on.
Zabranili su svojim vojnicima da pričaju šta su vidjeli, pošto su dokaze, nisu pozvali one što su trebali pozvati avione da bombarduju.
Znači, sve to išlo naprijed,
niko meni ne može reći da je neko tu.
This is all done for the purpose. Nobody could be stopped. It was planned, premeditated, but what we are doing now, we can't undo this, but we are trying to build a trust between people, to build factories and to get employment for people and to develop this trust between each other. We can live one by one next to one, but it's better to build some kind of unity.
Jasmila, your film has been awarded many prizes, many awards, and also including BAFTA and Oscar nominations. How has it been received by the European public? Tell me a little bit about like differences in perception across Europe's regions.
That was very interesting because each country had its own reasons to connect with the film. Like when we showed it in Poland, they were very touched by this huge rise of right wing, and people told me, if I see this film, I would think, who of my neighbors would do the same thing to me? Who is that? And you know, the people were connecting it with the different issues, like in Peru, where there are also people searching for their loved ones in the mass graves. They connected with this kind of feelings with the film. They could identify it with Aida especially. So it was different in each country in a different way. But what I was very happy about is that a lot of young people could connect to the film. You know, they were not even born when these things were happening. A lot of people didn't even hear about Srebrenica, young people. But they were able to connect with the film, and then most of them told me after watching the film, they went researching more, reading more about it, and that is, I think, very valuable that they feel it's a part of European history.
Is it now that, for example, the film has been shown, has been viewed by many Europeans across Europe, do you think that this, actually one of the purposes of this award is to support, not only to support European cinema, but also to spark debate. Do you think this will help young people, as you said, who do not know about Srebrenica, were not born back then, but also not only Srebrenica, other massacres and other, you know, genocidal events happening in the Balkans, in Kosovo and elsewhere, do you think this helps people connect over these stories more? And is this? Do Europeans need more of these films that tell our common, our shared history?
What I learned from reactions is that people want to see these films. Luckily, you know, we live in Europe where there are film funds who support these kind of films. If we are living in countries where there is only commercial value on board, it would be very hard to produce this film. And European values are that through arts and through films we can tell difficult stories that maybe will not take us to popcorn on Saturday night, but will give us other values. And I have feeling that people who see the film really appreciate it. Of course, it's a big question how to invite audience to see this kind of film, but LUX Award is definitely helping because more people are aware and more people want to see it.
Mrs. Subhadji, the last question to you. Actually, it's more of a request for a short message to those people who haven't seen the movie Kovadis Aida. Why should people watch this film? Why is it important, especially for Europeans, to watch this film? And what is your message to the Ukrainian mothers who are going through the same hardships today?
Pa evo, vrlo je važno da se vidi taj film. Ne zbog nas majki,
it's very important for this movie to be seen, not only for mothers from Srebrenica. We see that there is a right wing on the rise, a fascism is on the rise in Europe, which was extinguished 80 years ago. Children are born out of love, but we have to bring them up to learn something, because a man without a past cannot be a man in the future, but we have the
Moramo, znači,
we have to,
da što više je vidi mladi,
to fight
jer mladi su naša
and
budućnost.
To teach the young people
a kad vidi the film, best we can. Šta je stvarno,
but when they young people see such movies, then they can understand,
znači,
the grasp this idea of mistakes that were made in the past. By way of movies, we can reach out for the truth and build trust among ourselves. If we just ignore it, then nothing has happened. We will not have a history. We will have false history and a message to mothers of Ukraine to raise their voice as much as they can to plead for the killing of their children to be stopped or rape of their children. The sooner they react, the sooner the situation will change. If we are having children out of love, then we should try to prevent them from dying, and also kind Turkish mothers not to send their mothers to their children to fight in the war. Love should be spread all around.
Mrs. Munia Subasic, thank you very much for telling your story and for keeping your work to spread this message, the message of Mothers of Srebrenica, which is also the foundation you are leading.
Samo sam zaboravila reći da smo mi našu djecu koja su ostala bez svojih najmilijih odgojili i postali veliki ljudi bez mržnje i bez osveti. To je naš uspjeh, najveći uspjeh kojim se ja ponosim.
That the children that we that are alive, that stayed alive, that we brought up, they have become great people without hatred and full of love.
Absolutely.
In their hearts.
Absolutely, and we wish for many people to watch this movie. Congratulations again on the award, and I wish for you many more awards in the future and lots of success for the future projects. And if you still want to watch some of these nominated movies, including Kovadis Aida, a very chilling story about the Srebrenica massacre, you can still do it on the LUX Awards website. You can check the viewing dates on other European cities, and you can see how you can get it from your local providers. Thank you for following this interview, and I'll see you in future live interviews.